Hello. Today we're going to take a look at how to multiply a polynomial by a monomial. Let's start with a simple example. 3x times 4x plus 2. When multiplying a polynomial by a monomial, you'll want to multiply each part of the polynomial, which is this part right here, by each part of the monomial, which is this part right here. So that'll look like this. You'll multiply the monomial 3x by the first part of the polynomial, so by this 4x. So we'll have 3x times 4x. And then we'll add, multiplying the monomial by this part of the polynomial, the plus 2. So then we'll have plus 3x times positive 2. So now all we have to do is multiply each of these sets of monomials. So we're going to multiply 3x by 4x and get 12x squared. And then 3x times 2 is 6x, so plus 6x. And that's our answer. Not too challenging. Let's try another one. 7y squared times 2y squared plus 6y minus 9. Now remember, we have to multiply each part of the polynomial by this monomial. So we're going to start by multiplying 7y squared by 2y squared. So we'll have 7y squared times 2y squared plus 7y squared times 6y plus 7y squared times negative 9. Notice that I put plus signs between each set of multiplied terms, even though there is a negative 9. I did this because subtraction is always the same thing as adding a negative number. Our last sign will end up turning into a subtraction symbol, but doing it this way helps us make sure that we have the correct signs attached to each term. So I pulled the negative 9 over here where we're going to multiply it instead of making this a subtraction sign. So now let's multiply all of our terms. So 7y squared times 2y squared is 14y to the fourth. Remember, when you multiply exponential terms with the same base, you simply add the exponents. So we got 2 plus 2 is 4, so that's where the y to the fourth came from. And then 7y squared times 6y is 42y cubed, so plus 42y cubed. And then plus 7y squared times negative 9 is negative 63y squared. Now remember what I said earlier, adding a negative number is the same thing as subtracting. So we can rewrite this as 14y to the fourth plus 42y cubed minus 63y squared. And that's our final answer. Before we go, let's try one last problem. Negative 5x squared y times 3x minus 5xy plus 10y squared. We need to multiply each term of the polynomial by the monomial. So we'll multiply negative 5x squared y by 3x, and then add negative 5x squared y times negative 5xy. Don't forget to pull the sign right here. Plus negative 5x squared y times 10y squared. Now we need to multiply each set of the monomials. Remember, a negative times a negative is a positive. So we'll have negative 5x squared y times 3x is negative 15. X squared times x is x cubed, and then y. Plus, here's negative 5 times negative 5, so this will be a positive 25. X squared times x is x cubed, and y times y is y squared. Plus, negative 5 times 10 is negative 50, so we'll have negative 50, x squared, and y times y squared is y cubed. We can simplify this last sign, and our final answer will be negative 15 x cubed y plus 25 x cubed y squared minus 50 x squared y cubed. I hope that this video on multiplying polynomials by monomials has been helpful. Thanks for watching and happy studying!